students from Avamere Health Services, sponsored here in Avamere of Eugene. I'm having a brain bubble, sorry. Please know that we are recording for upload to YouTube Live. Well, it won't be live, but we're going to be uploading it to YouTube. So people at home can watch it later on if they want to. People that weren't able to attend because it's kind of an inconvenient time, they'll be able to watch it later on. All my ceremonies are recorded, almost all of them, and uploaded. So you can watch various ones if you're interested in any other ones in Salem, Kaiser. You can probably watch a lot of those. I want to begin by reading, I probably should tell you who I am. I'm Misty Gordon. I'm the program director for the nursing assistant program here in Oregon. And I helped instruct these students at the end of their clinical, and they're pretty great. We're pretty proud of them. We're going to begin by reading a poem. It's pretty famous, although the author is unknown. The poem is found among the possessions of an elderly lady who lived in a geriatric ward of a hospital. No information is really available concerning her, at least from the source that I found this from. Who she was or when she died, it was anonymous. And it's called See Me. What do you see, nurses? What do you see? Are you thinking when you look at me? A crabby old woman, not very wise, uncertain of habit with far away eyes, who dribbles her food and makes no reply when you say in a loud voice, I do wish you'd try. Who seems not to notice the things that you do and forever is losing a stocking or a shoe. Who, unresisting or not, lets you do as you will. Puns are too important to miss. Sorry, guys. With bathing and feeding the long day to fill. Then open your eyes, nurse. Open your eyes. You're looking at me. I'll tell you who I am as I sit here so still. As I rise at your bidding, as I eat at your will. I'm a small child of 10 with a father and mother, brothers and sisters who love one another, a young girl of 16 with wings on her feet, dreaming that soon now a lover she'll meet, a bride soon at 20, my heart gives a leap, remembering the vows that I promised to keep. At 25, now I have young of my own, who need me to build a secure, happy home. A woman of 30, my young now grow fast, bound to each other with ties that should last. At 40, my young sons have grown and are gone, but my man's beside me to see I don't mourn. At 50, once more, babies play round my knee. Again, we know children, my loved one. Dark days are upon me. My husband is dead. I look at the future, I shudder with dread, for my young are all rearing young of their own, and I think of the years and the love that I've known. I'm an old woman now, and nature is cruel. 'Tis her jest to make old age look like a fool. The body's crumbled, grace and vigor depart. There's now a stone where once I had a heart. But inside this old carcass, a young girl still dwells, and now and again, my battered heart swells. I remember the joys, I remember the pain, and I'm loving and living life over again. I think of the years, all too few, gone too fast, and accept the stark fact that nothing can last. So I open your eyes, nurses. Open and see. Not a crabby old woman. Look closer, nurses. See me. So again, my name's Misty Gordon. I'm an Oregon State Board of Nursing approved primary instructor and the program director for Avamere's Oregon program. Avamere's program is one of the very few community-based nursing assistant programs here in Oregon, and we're proud to say we're on track to helping produce several hundred newly certified nursing assistants each calendar year. Over the last several years, I've worked with dozens of students in some capacity through this program, and I must say that every day I'm finding myself more grateful each time for the chance to do so. The nursing assistant class you're about to recognize has worked hard to get to this point since day one. They reviewed and studied 56 chapters and materials. They've taken 14 daily quizzes. They've taken 3 tests and a final, and they were all successful. They then went to the floor and over time dedicated over 75 hours each of their personal time, sacrificing their families, their personal lives, their jobs, their commitments, and their sanity to complete the amount of hours required by the Oregon State Board of Nursing to demonstrate competence and skill at the level of an entry-level nursing assistant. I can personally attest to the difficulty and frustration one experiences going through the classroom and lab experience for a nursing career. These students have practiced and repracticed skills, have endured the funny looks they invariably get when retaining a vital or practicing a skill under the scrutiny of not only me, but the patients, their families, and their staff members. Every class is different. Every class has their own quirks and fears and challenges. Every class has their, as nurse place, Blake would classify them. They have their worrier, or the perfectionist, or the anxious one, or the shy one. This class was no different. And of course, they've had their own set of challenges to overcome. But what is most remarkable to me is the teamwork they have shown to one another. They've come together, worked together, and have supported one another through this process and now sit at the finish line. I was lucky to have been able to teach these students. It was a joy to be with them, and thanks to them, I look forward to each day in both the classroom and on the floor. My story as a CNA began in 2001, where I began as a student technician at a large teaching hospital on the East Coast. It was an amazing experience, and this is where I learned to love nursing, to identify with patients as people, not as a room number or a diagnosis. I can attribute my work ethic and values to the people surrounding me, the people that encouraged me to go to school when I thought I would never be able to do so, the people that helped me navigate financial aid and student loans, too bad they aren't here to help me pay them, the people that supported my education and explained concepts, studied with me, and endured my incessant questions, and there were many. I owe it all to people, people just like you. My point is, I absolutely would not be where I am today, here with all of you, and with these truly spectacular group of graduates, if it were not for these people. I tell you these things because I want you to know that it is never just one person that makes it possible for a person to attend school and achieve the needed educational requirements for career advancement. It literally takes a village. Students, husbands, wives, life partners, children, sisters and brothers, aunts, uncles, grandparents, friends, and of course the administrative staff and patients of supporting facilities. We all make it happen. So on this day, I want us all to take a moment to offer a round of applause to all persons present and to those who may be watching live or not so live, who have in some way influenced and helped these students along their path. And how much their communities will benefit from their work. If there's only one place in the world that understands what kind of work goes into becoming a CNA, I want them to know it was here under the guidance of our primary instructors. Because of this, we wanted the students to experience a true graduation ceremony, a pinning ceremony. When I came to this program as primary instructor over 2 years ago, I made a point to ensure that I recognize the accomplishments of the students. At that time, we were one active location in Salem. Now, as program director, I want to ensure that we continue that recognition. Many students work full-time, care for children, their single parents, their caregivers to family members. They're single-handedly supporting a family, all while attending school and clinical. That's not easy, guys. Clinical is 8 hours a day, plus the commute time, and class time is at least 6 hours a day. And they're masterfully pulling it off. The recognition for this sort of accomplishment cannot be too big. This graduation is a turning point in the lives of these six graduate nursing assistants. It's a commitment in the hearts and minds of those who receive the pin. It symbolizes your impending entry into the noblest and most respected profession in the world. I sincerely hope you are all as proud of your accomplishments as we are. We would now like to individually recognize these students, these future Oregon State Board of Nursing certified nursing assistants, these future leaders in care, these human beings that give so much of their time and heart to the patients here and now and in their futures. I'm going to ask that each student, as they're called, they come up to accept their certificate and their pin, and they'll remain seated here until all the students are together. photo op. So before we introduce each student, I'm going to read a quote from someone. These people influenced our ways of thinking about nursing, life, philosophy, and love, and they've remained in our hearts, including mine, long after their departure from this earth. One can only hope that they have the care of individuals, such as this nursing assistant class, to care for them in their final hours. In nursing school, we were prohibited from posting anything on social media that related to our classes. So one of our peers developed a Facebook page under the pseudonym of Florence Nightingale. She posted notes and tricks, tips, anything she found helpful in school. She's one of my cohort and is a well-respected nurse practicing in South Carolina. That was nursing. Sharing knowledge, educating where you can, and setting an example, shining a light for others to follow. And she said, how very little can be done under the spirit of fear. Florence Nightingale. Actually, Emily was the nurse that I was talking about, but the quote is from Florence Nightingale. So this is going to be for Cyan. Short story writer, an essayist, a biographer, historian, and a diplomat of the early 19th century. These words remind me of the beauty of not only of birth, but of death. Caring for the elderly when they can no longer do so for themselves is a passion that holds a special place in the nursing community. Bravery tries to. And he said, it really did, he said, there's a sacredness in tears. They are not the mark of weakness, but of power. They speak more eloquently than 10,000 tongues. They are messengers of overwhelming grief and unspeakable love. Washington Irving. Amber Petrillo. Comedian and actor. His movie, Patch Adams, is one of the reasons I'm a nurse today. I've always said he had kind eyes, my favorite. His smile and laugh were infectious. If you have a moment tonight, say a little prayer for this man who passed away at the age of only 63 due to issues related to mental illness. And he said, in a movie, no matter what people tell you, words and ideas can change this world. Robin Williams. Stephen Thompson. memoirist and a civil rights activist, and one of my favorite authors of all time. Her writings have put my thoughts into print, and I often wondered if we would have been friends were we to ever have been neighbors. And she said, "They may forget your name, but they will never forget how you made them feel." Maya Angelou. Man was an American essayist, a lecturer, a philosopher, and a poet who lived in the 1800s. His quote rings very true for me. I firmly believe that our past does not dictate our future. And he said, "What lies behind you and what lies in front of you pales in comparison to what lies inside of you." Ralph Waldo Emerson. Jennifer was an American essayist. I lied. This one is almost immediately recognizable upon describing him. He's one of my all-time favorite childhood characters, and I was nicknamed after him as a child. I often have to stop and think about what he says here, because sometimes life can be a little overwhelming. And he said, "You're braver than you believe, and stronger and smarter than you think." Winnie the Pooh.